Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take on his reaction to a song of Kent. The song is Mannen, I den Vita Hatten. That means a man in the white hat 16 years later is also part of the title. It's a request of our patron Jono. A small excerpt Jono gave because it probably will be in Swedish language. It means a man in a white hat means on the day of the graduation, would you?
Okay, yeah. And we have the English lyrics though. I think it's done by somebody.
Hmm.
We are not sure how accurate it is.
Hmm.
Online, we just got it from Google. Hmm. So we've got the lyrics because without that, it might, you know, we won't understand what
nothing
is being sung,
yeah,
at all.
Yeah.
So this is for our patron Jono. Let's get started with our first time single take honest reaction. We listen to music without pausing the music that we are listening to the songs. And we also do not pause or edit our recording. Whatever we are saying now, it goes to you the same way without any cuts or edits in the video. And we arrange it beautifully for you in frames so you can see us more clearly. And the song, if there are lyrics or if something like that, then we add that for you to get it more easily, what we are listening to or seeing on the screen. It's very important that we say that we give honest reactions and we listen to music without discrimination, as in the case here. It's a song from a totally different part of the world than us, out of our comfort zone, but still we listen to it and we give an honest, open review to the music. Let's get started with it. Kent, the man in the white hat, 16 years later.
Yeah. skrattar åt mig förminskar alltid men jag ser på din ängsliga hållning din jagade blick att det känns att det är långt hem och snart finns det inga tår.
Translation in the video. Wow, beautiful, beautiful reflection, thought process, contemplation, and very futuristic ideas and thoughts shared in the lyrics of this song. Beautifully written. I don't know if who's written it. One of the members of Kent, I would imagine. Mannen, I then Vita Hatten, the man in the white hat. Oh, beautifully, beautifully done. I like the music. It reminded me a little bit of bands such as U2, Porcupine Tree. Liked it. I liked the way it was sung. The vocals were so clear, sharp, and sounded so good in this one. This is a really good song of Kent. Not like some of the others I've heard. This is much better than that.
Much deeper,
different quality. As far as the way it goes, the flow of the music, the arrangement, the haunting sound of the piano throughout the song almost. There's so much in there as far as the guitar work is concerned, the drums, the vocals. It's kind of epic the way this is done. It's crafted beautifully. I'm assuming it must have been a really big hit of Kent when this came out and even months and years later if it's an old song. This is definitely one of the best songs of Kent ever, by far. I mean, in general in music, it's a really, really good song I've heard today. And yeah, I like the way it was sung, more than the lyrics, the way it was sung. The musical arrangement is just pulls you into it, into, you know, the groove, gives you that kind of experience. And it's really beautiful to listen to. Let's see what Kirti has to say as the chief of Enoma, her thoughts and feelings on this song by Kent.
It's very powerful to listen to this song. That is a very unique quality of this song. Whether we understood the language or not that was being sung, the translation of the song is slightly vague, I would say. Probably it's a topic that we won't directly understand even if the translation is correct. But I like the way it was sung. I like the music, the way the music was playing right. Perfectly blending with the vocals that were singing. It was made to be powerful. It was made to be effective on people who listen to it. I think a very slight idea I got. I know the countries in Scandinavia are, completely different from countries that are there in South Asia, Southeast Asia, or completely different from North America, completely different from South America, the way they approach life, their outlook to life, the way they look at things, the way they live, lifestyle, etc. Essentially, we are all humans, but the way of living and lifestyle and philosophy changes. Looking at the lyrics, probably it is a story of a guy and a girl who may have a child who they are trying to abandon or something like that. Maybe because of some rule, some law. The blood oath was mentioned here. I'm just guessing here. Or something like that. And then towards the end, there was a mention of the human incubator. I don't think it's about a baby's incubator. I'm thinking about for people, there are some things done where death of dying is mentioned, which he does not agree with. Maybe trying to prolong life of people or lifespan with some scientific ways. I don't know what exactly it is, but he is not in support of it. He says, we all have to die one day. So some things are mentioned which aren't that common this side. Maybe not even heard of this side, but maybe something big deal over there.
I don't get all that, but I like the way it was sung.
Yeah.
And the music, definitely it's on the darker side and dealing with some issues which I am not aware of, and neither is Kirti apparently.
Yeah.
So we don't really want to get into it because it could easily be misunderstood,
misinterpreted
and also be wrong. Whatever
we know nothing and interpret it. Yeah,
that's it for this one. We really enjoyed the song though. I really like the way it was played and sung. Beautiful, definitely the best song of Kent ever.
Yeah.